I'm going to show you how you can turn your terminal from this into this. And by the end of this video, you can have a terminal setup that will not just impress your friends, but will actually make you a more productive developer. Let's get started. Surprisingly, or not surprisingly, one of the biggest changes that you'll see in your terminal is the font. There are a lot of amazing free fonts online that are made specifically for terminals and code editors. So here are some of my favorites. Yozevka, hopefully I'm saying that right, has a lot of variations to it. And it's great for your code editor as well as your terminal. They also got cool ligatures as well. Source Code Pro by Adobe is also a very popular choice by techies who want to have a really cool techie font, but also want something readable. Hack, another popular font that is also open source and is used often in code editors. There's a ton of free fonts online that you can download and try for yourself. Even just changing the font on your terminal makes the experience a lot better. Now, one of the biggest differences that you're gonna see when you put this in your terminal is Oh My Zsh Shell. And yes, it's pronounced Oh My Zsh Shell, not Oh My Zsh. Oh My Zsh Shell is really easy to install. You just copy this command into your terminal and you're done. Restart your terminal and you have this beautiful interface. What this does is gives insane flexibility and customization to your terminal by incorporating plugins and themes that just dramatically change the way that you use your terminal. And there's a lot of different plugins. So here are some of my favorites. Sudo, make it so you can add sudo at the beginning of the command you just entered. When you forgot to put it in, just hit escape twice and you're good to go. Web search, whenever you need to do a quick Google of something, use the Google command that will open up your browser and look for something on Google. Git. For me, I'm always using Git in the terminal because I think it's just a little bit faster. Of course, though, typing out a Git command can sometimes be extremely long. Like, come on. The Git command shortens everything, so you can just condense it into this small command rather than writing out this super long one. Like, GA is Git add, or GC is Git commit. But of course, utility, function, like I'm not here for that. I want something that looks really cool. And the themes are also incredible when it comes to Oh My Zsh Shell. Pure gives you a terminal, a much more minimal look. Still very pretty in terms of color and design, but minimal. Bullet Train gives you this terminal, as in like an airport terminal. Looking design that has these pills that show you what time it is, the current directory, and a Git branch. However, the best has to go to power level 10K. Installation is pretty easy. Since we already have the Zsh Shell, we can copy the repository. I'm just using the command in the documentation. Then once that is installed, we go into our Zsh Shell RC file and add in the Zsh Shell theme key. And you might actually see a difference, but it also comes with a configuration command as well. Run p10k configure, and it runs you through a helpful wizard of what you want. If you want to be lean, you can do that. If you want in a style to bullet train, then you can also do that too. But my favorite, rainbow style. You can customize this for days. And this also comes with a huge amount of extras as well. No matter what developer you are, there's lots, like Node version manager, Python environments, Go environment manager. And after you configure, just look at your terminal. Just with this install, you've leveled up your terminal like crazy. Your friends are gonna be really impressed with what they see. However, we can make it even better. If you watch our video on 15 commands that every developer should know, which, you know, you should definitely check that out, then you know about the cat command. But if not, it's a simple command that will output the contents of a file. However, it's a bit bare bones. You would be incentivized to open it somewhere else. And this is where bat comes in, with a B, not a C. If you're in the terminal and the command line, you most likely are a programmer or looking at code. And with bat, you get syntax highlighting, similar to a code editor, Git integration so that you can see the difference in things, automatic paging, and more. And just like the other tools in here, it's a simple installation as well. Just one line and it's installed. Using bat is similar to how you would with the cat command, so no introduction is really necessary. But being able to use this instead of the simple black and white terminal makes it so much easier on the eyes. And it's also extremely fast. The idea is to be in the terminal for most of our day-to-day things. So peeking into files with bat is an absolute no-brainer. How many times are we gonna say this joke? CD, LS, CD, LS, CD, LS. It's actually so annoying to navigate our directories in the terminal sometimes. This is partly because when you are navigating your directory, you don't really have an idea of where you are or what's available. But with FZF, or Fuzzy Finder, you have this Fuzzy Finder in your terminal that is a general purpose tool. So the example I used above is just one use case to this, being able to search your directories for something and enter that directory. However, this can be used in so many different ways because it's designed as a general purpose tool. You can also search your history of commands. You can use it in your Git commands. shell autocompletion, and NeoVim for text editing. Depending on your operating system, installation varies. However, you're likely to just be able to download it with one command. And since I'm on Mac, I can easily just use brew install FCF. After that, you can use the brew prefix command, which is in the documentation, to install key bindings. And that's it, the setup is super easy. However, we now need to bind this into our CD command so that we can actually use it. We can go into our .zshrc file and create a command. Funny enough, I needed ChatGPT to do this one, so I linked the command in the description. Paste this in and then run source.zshrc. This just resets your command line. And now let's give it a try. Perfect. It's an amazing way to quickly navigate your files. FCF is a very flexible tool, so you can use it in way more places than just this. On Mac, there's one thing you need to install if you haven't already. Homebrew is the missing package manager for macOS. It's really easy to use and install and has a huge community behind it. When it comes to installing developer dependencies like MySQL, OpenSSL, or anything, Homebrew has a really simple command for it. I'll follow the homepage, but it's as simple as just pasting in one command and it's installed. Then you can do things like brew install wget, and there it is right there on your terminal. Outside of command line tools, you can also install GUI software. You know that weird thing on Mac where it's like, you know, drag to install and you have to like drag the icon over to the applications folder? Well, with --cask, you can easily be able to skip the step. And if you code in Ruby, then Homebrew is even better for you because everything is simple Ruby scripts, so you can customize everything to your liking. But I'm not a Ruby dev, so it's not gonna be me. Now, the ls command is iconic, and my brain can't really stop typing ls every time I enter a new directory. Exa is a modern replacement. It's very lightweight and gives some pretty awesome features right out of the gate, like colors for different data, slash file types, more information, and Git support. It's a one-line install for Linux and Mac, so because I'm on Mac, I'm going to do a brew install of it. You can now use Exa in the command line to see it in action. Of course, though, I'm never going to trick my brain into using the Exa command. It's always going to be ls. So I'm going to create an alias for ls that just uses the Exa command. I'll open my zshellrc file in Vim and add it to the bottom of the file. Run the source command now, and there we go. Much easier and hassle-free. And if you want to see some content on Vim, let us know in the comments below. One last tool, and that's Diff So Fancy. Diff So Fancy is a way to make your diffs human readable instead of all crazy and hard to look at. Let's say you're using git diff to, you know, see the changes in a code base. You're often just struggling to just see what you're looking at. Diff So Fancy makes this much easier to deal with since everything is color coded beautifully. Installation, also easy. I'm just gonna use Homebrew again, but you can also do it with NPM. Then to switch out the diff command from git, you run a simple git config command. You can also use this as a replacement for the diff command as well. Outside of programming, there might be a scenario where you want to see the differences between two versions of a file, let's say. What I like about this is that it keeps me in the terminal and makes it really easy to see the difference. Again, it's an old tool, but it just works so well that it's awesome. Thanks for watching today's video. There are a ton of tools that you can use in the terminal that can just max your productivity and also just kind of look cool. Make sure you check out our video, 15 command line tools that every developer should know to max your productivity as a developer. Thanks for watching.